Michaels reporting from ringside in San Juan. Big question at the outset in regard to Rosario is the fact that he suffered a broken bone in his right wrist last June. He has not fought in 11 months. Here we go. WBC rules, thus a 12-round championship fight. And if the referee, who in this case is Arthur Mercanti, so decides, a standing 8-count can be ordered. Ramirez out of Mexico, a southpaw, a reported record of 83-3. But he dealt in relative obscurity for quite some time. It wasn't until late 1980 when he fought Alexis Arguello that he came into some form of prominence, as Arguello won a split decision in Miami. Meanwhile, Rosario, a reported 24-0 with 23 knockouts. He's been the distance just one time, at a 10-rounder in Vegas in 1981. But again, the fractured right wrist. He had it in the cast for 4 months, and it's only been within the last 6 weeks that he was able to test it out at full speed. Good right. First time he employs it here in the first round. Rosario has been fighting as a junior lightweight, but he was ranked number one in this class by virtue of his victory, very impressively, over another Puerto Rican, Edwin Viruet, in Las Vegas last May. That was the last time Rosario fought, because the injury occurred in a sparring session a couple of weeks after that, as he was preparing to fight Cubanito Perez. Good combination by Rosario. Ramirez, a crafty fighter. On a couple of instances in that fight with Arguello in 1980, it looked like he was in trouble, but then he was able to counter effectively, and indeed had Arguello in trouble at one particular point, had him down on the canvas in the seventh round. First round action from Puerto Rico. Ramirez also took on the WBA champion, Ray Boom Boom Mancini, and that was perhaps the low light of his career, as he lost the unanimous decision and was very nearly shut out on all of the cards. Contended that the ring surface that day was too slippery for him. Rosario pressing the action in the first round. Ramirez backing up for the most part. Half a minute to go in round one. WBC World Lightweight Championship at stake. Ramirez trying to work his way into the left that was picked off. Now Ramirez starting to press the action with that right jab. Rosario coming back with a right that was partially picked off as the first round concludes in San Juan.
Vamos al segundo capítulo del compromiso a 12, versión del Consejo Mundial de Boxeo con la nueva regla de menos de 15 asaltos en las 135 libras. El Chapo Rosario, según los tres jueces que vieron el primer asalto, los tres, con excepción de Lou Filippo, le dieron el primer asalto al Chapo Rosario. Estamos a la altura del segundo asalto. El árbitro lo es Arthur Mercanti. No vota, según las el reglamento del Consejo Mundial de Boxeo, y para aquellos nuevos en este deporte del boxeo, pero que son fanáticos y lo siguen, la votación que se utilizó durante el transcurso de los 12 asaltos fue 10 puntos para el ganador, 9 para el perdedor, independientemente con una evaluación si se produjeran caídas o un ataque sumamente duro de parte de uno de los contrarios, de los oponentes, pero realmente eso no se suscitó, un combate parejo que ha levantado una serie de interrogantes muy interesantes, y esta noche ustedes van a tener la oportunidad de emitir su propio juicio al particular.
Not much real hitting thus far in the round. For the most part it was Rosario pressing the action in the first round until the waning second. Good right there. But Ramirez is a good counterpuncher, as he proved against Arguello. Another right, and a good right by Rosario. The crowd really coming to life as he has Ramirez backing up, but Ramirez came back, as we mentioned. He's a great puncher. Being a southpaw, he came back with a right hook that forced Rosario back after Edwin was very much pressing the issue. He did get Edwin's attention with the right hook. 1 minute remaining in the second round. Both men capable of knocking his opponent out, the record proving that. But both quite crafty and skillful. Here comes Rosario again, putting that pressure on. Rivera's trying to keep him off with that sticking right. And Mercanti steps in to separate them. Under a half minute remaining in the second round. Live from San Juan, Puerto Rico. Folks down here with great anticipation for this fight. And of course, it's a pro-Rosario crowd. He lives just 20 miles away from San Juan. Second round ending.
Estamos a la altura del tercer asalto, el asalto anterior, precisamente los tres jueces, Luffy Luke, Luke Tavar y Spider Bannum, se lo otorgaron al puertorriqueño Edwin Rosario. Estén pendientes. En este asalto, supuestamente, Rosario se afecta sus nudillos en su mano derecha, así que vamos a disfrutar del asalto. La ventaja, aunque ligera, es para el puertorriqueño hasta estos momentos.
José Luis Ramírez of Mexico. The two fighting for the vacated lightweight crown, vacated when Alexis Arguello concentrates or decided to concentrate his effort in the junior welterweight class in January. Thus, Rosario ranked number one, Ramirez ranked number two. Rosario, a fractured bone in his right wrist last June, has not fought since May of 1982. Rosario, undefeated, 24-0 with 23 knockouts. And José Luis Ramírez reported 83-3 with 69 of his wins coming by way of the knockout route. Ramírez, the southpaw. First round, Rosario put most of the pressure on. It was a relatively inactive round, but it was Rosario, the aggressor early. Then in the second round, Rosario appeared to sting Ramirez, but Ramirez, a very effective counterpuncher, came back with, and keep in mind he's a southpaw, came back with a right hook that pushed Rosario away and certainly gained his attention. And thus the round perhaps could have been scored for either man. Three judges at ringside doing the scoring. Good right by Rosario. The referee, Arthur Mercanti, no voice in the scoring. Third round. Boston Michigan game, it is over, and the final score was 28-24. Michigan Panthers winning it. Here, 25 seconds remaining. We're in the third round. Ramirez trying to work his way inside. A good left by Ramirez. Ramirez, 24 years old. Rosario, 20. WBC World Lightweight Championship fight from San Juan into the third round right here. Fourth round action. This has the makings of a good one. Lightweight championship at stake, WBC version. Edwin Rosario, the black trunks. On the left, José Luis Ramírez of Mexico in the dark blue trunks. Ramirez has him in the corner and see if he's effective here using that right jab, but Rosario is able to work his way out. 20-foot ring here in San Juan. Rosario quite mobile. controlling the pace and tempo thus far in the fourth round. Stations along the line at the end of this round. We'll be taking a station break. We have just over a minute remaining in the fourth round. Ramirez countering, but Rosario picking off most of those punches. Rosario again backed into the corner. Starting to throw a few more punches. A quick left by Rosario. And he comes back with a left hook with under a half minute to go in the fourth round. Seconds left in the fourth round. And we'll return with more of ABC's Wide World of Sports after this from our local stations.
Finalizado el primer tercio del combate, por primera ocasión se produce ya la situación de desbalance en lo que respecta a las votaciones. Con excepción del segundo asalto no ha habido uniformidad en lo que se refiere a la votación. El segundo asalto hubo unanimidad de criterios entre Filippo, Tabat y Bynum votando a favor de Rosario. Pero indistintamente el primero, el tercero y el cuarto asalto ha venido la variante de quién realmente ganó para cada uno de estos tres caballeros, donde Archie Mercante, referí, repetimos, no tiene ningún poder decisional en lo que se refiere a votación de ganador y peleador. Pero sin lugar a dudas, hasta el momento, la técnica depurada, la movilidad, el sentido de la distancia y la fortaleza de la pegada ha sido el índice demostrativo del puertorriqueño. Sin lugar a dudas que el mexicano hasta estos momentos ha sido un formidable oponente.
Rosario, who was backed against the ropes a couple of times in the fourth round, hand punch coming off the ropes just to ask Edwin Buriuet. He did that, knocked him down in the second round and knocked him out in the third. In Vegas, crowd chanting Chapo, Chapo, the nickname, the name he wears across his waist on the black trunks. There is a C there. There it is as he turns. Good left by Ramirez and a wild right, but he did score with a left hand. Rosario turning. But now back comes Rosario. And the crowd getting to its feet and chanting as Rosario puts the pressure on. But Ramirez backs off the rope. Now he's got Rosario in the corner. And we're trying to fight his way out. A good left hand. That stung Ramirez. A good left hand coming out of the corner by Rosario. Again, almost by design, he gets himself into the corner because he's been effective working himself out of there. 45 seconds remaining in the fifth round. Both fighters like to counterpunch, and so Curry is of inaction as they await the other, awaiting the instigation of action. Good right again by Rosario. Been a good round for him. His best And the best round of the fight thus far. Waning seconds of the fifth round. A good one and another good short right by Rosario, the WBC lightweight crown stake.
Bien, y en el asalto anterior definitivamente no hay lugar a dudas de quién fue el ganador. Ahí tiene la repetición de una descomunal izquierda en forma de gancho pegada frente al mexicano. Estén analizando la técnica implementada por Manny Ciaca, la esquina de Chapo Rosario, donde Chapo Rosario básicamente ha sido un gran peleador en el área intermedia, media del cuadrilátero. Hizo una pelea en las esquinas frente a las sogas, tratando de quitarle el punto fuerte de riposta a Ramírez y llevándolo dentro del sistema de pelea de Rosario, teniendo que Ramírez atacar al hombre que está frente a la soga. Y hay un punto bien interesante: la estamina de Rosario, aún él personalmente sabía que no era la mejor luego de 11 meses de inactividad, y por eso es que aunque estaba corriendo todo el cuadrilátero, estaba descansando sobre la soga e impulsándose a favor de la soga para quitarle la riposta de Ramírez. Eso fue un factor decisivo para mí, entiendo, en el resultado final del combate, que aunque usted lo vea una gran cantidad de veces, va a determinar de que fue un combate interesante y sumamente cerrado. Something he was very effective at doing in round five.
The two fighting for the lightweight championship. The crown vacated by Alexis Arguello. Ray Boom Boom Mancini is the WBA lightweight champion.
Arribamos ya a la parte más allá de la mitad del combate, donde en el asalto anterior, aunque Rosario lució técnicamente con más fortaleza en la parte inicial del mismo, el poder de recuperación del mexicano fue realmente increíble, hasta el extremo de que dos de los jueces que habían estado votando consistentemente con lo que estaba sucediendo, a mi entender, sobre el cuadrilátero, votaron dos a favor de Ramírez, uno a favor de Rosario. Ya Rosario está muy consciente y debe estar en esos momentos pensando de que este hombre no se ha caído hasta esos momentos con su pegada y que posiblemente tendrá que recurrir a correr la distancia frente a un formidable y peligroso oponente como lo ha sido hasta esos momentos el mexicano.
For Phillies, Wide World beginning 3:30 Eastern next Saturday, followed by the Kentucky Derby. One minute gone in the seventh round. Also on Wide World next week, World Show Jumping Championship from Ireland, World Record High Dive Challenge from San Diego. To do some scoring as he lands a couple of decent blows, and he'll have to pick up the action here in the pace because he would figure that Rosario, on the basis of what he has done through the first six rounds, spotting a pattern here that he's exhibited in the past couple of rounds, maybe even the past three or four, and that is starting slowly and then coming on in the second half of a round. He certainly did it in five and six, and he has started slowly, and now he's coming on again here in round seven. But back comes Ramirez.
Del puertorriqueño el Chapo Rosario cuando en la parte final del sexto asalto el mexicano Ramírez atacó vigorosamente, tuvo que recuperarse el boricua Rosario, y en esta parte final precisamente del séptimo asalto tuvo Rosario que sobreponerse al fuerte castigo que ha estado recibiendo principalmente en su ojo izquierdo. Ha comenzado a hinchársele y definitivamente es el combate más brutal que ha tenido en toda su brillante y joven carrera de apenas 20 años de edad, el puertorriqueño Edwin Rosario. En la esquina, el formidable mexicano José Luis Ramírez, que definitivamente nunca ha tenido la suerte que él ha estado buscando. Ha fallado en los combates realmente importantes frente a Olivares, frente a Alexis Argüello, frente a Bum Bum Mancini por el campeonato norteamericano de las 135 libras, pero que sin lugar a dudas ha sido un rival peligroso, tal vez el mejor en toda la carrera del Chapo Rosario.
Rosario, for the most part, has controlled the pace and tempo of this fight. Ramirez, though, did come back with a good round in the seventh to make a good case for giving it to him. Again, referee Arthur Mercanti does not score. The three judges at ringside do. 10-point must have. And under the relatively recent WBC edict, a 12-round championship fight, not 15. We're in the eighth. Pressure again here put on by Ramirez. But Rosario gets him backing away again with two quick sticking left jabs. So Rosario throughout the fight exhibiting the tendency to get himself almost by design, as we said before, backed into a corner and then works his way out with great effectiveness. Ramirez, he's what you might call in the boxing terminology, a traitor. Likes to trade blows, as we said, an effective counterpuncher. Ramirez, at the age of 24, a pro since he was 14 years old, so a long road for him. Attempting to culminate it successfully today for the world title. 1 minute remaining in the eighth round. One thing about Rosario, if that right hand has bothered him in any way, he has not exhibited overtly. Again, the fractured wrist. He was in a cast for 4 months after it was originally diagnosed as something other than a fracture. And then intensive training only in the last 6 weeks. 20 seconds remaining, eighth round. Ramirez pressing, as was the case in the seventh and preceding round. Rosario again working his way out of the corner. And the eighth round is nearly history.
Luego de haber trascendido el séptimo asalto, donde por primera ocasión los tres oficiales norteamericanos coincidieron en que el ganador lo fue el mexicano Ramírez, otorgándole el séptimo asalto, el asalto anterior, el octavo, estamos en el inicio del noveno, dos de esos jueces se lo otorgaron al Chapo Rosario. Y por segunda ocasión en el desafío de la pelea, el mexicano Ramírez logra dos asaltos de forma seguida. Al menos ahí es el punto de cambio donde empieza el convencimiento en los jueces de que Ramírez está viniendo de atrás e imponiendo su estilo. Tenía para mí a Rosario al frente, a prácticamente la mitad del combate, pero la preocupación de Rosario por su problema en su arco superciliar izquierdo y el hinchazón en esa área del ojo lo llevó a prácticamente pelear en el centro del cuadrilátero, parte del asalto que estamos en consideración en estos momentos y el desarrollo final del combate.
Rosario early in his career with a lot of very early knockouts, but again, you have to consider the caliber of opposition. It wasn't that terrific, but he did open everybody's eyes by knocking out Bruyette in three, even though a lot of people felt that Bruyette was over the hill at that point. Halfway through the ninth round, I'd like to alert our local stations. At the end of this round, we'll be taking a station break. Ninth round scheduled, 12-rounder in San Juan. Again now, Ramirez, as has been the case in the last three rounds, has picked up the pace, and he has begun to make the fight. Rosario is doing some occasional scoring, and he's showing good footwork and foot speed. But he has not landed with nearly the effectiveness of late that he did in the middle round. But now here he comes, as if on cue. And of course, Rosario's relative inactiveness, and we say that guardedly in the last two rounds, could be attributed to ring rustiness. Let's face it, he hasn't fought since the end of May of 82. And he's in with a very good lightweight and Ramirez, a man with great experience, and a man who's beginning to score. We'll return with more of ABC's Wide World of Sports right after this from our local station.
Bien, amigos, vamos a la altura del décimo asalto. Indudablemente se recuperó el puertorriqueño en el asalto anterior, cuando esto condujo a los tres oficiales norteamericanos a darle la ventaja en el asalto. Rosario, desde el 1979, cuando peleó con Héctor Sánchez, haciendo el equipo nacional para Puerto Rico en los Juegos Panamericanos que se celebraron aquí, no peleaba con un zurdo. Conclusión, nunca había peleado con un zurdo como profesional y escogió el mal momento de ese día en el profesor Roberto Clemente para tener que pelear con él, porque esa pelea era compulsoria del Consejo Mundial de Boxeo. Rosario era número uno clasificado, el número dos era el mexicano, y tenían que pelear entre sí para buscar un campeonato. Y aunque no había instrucciones específicas, no podía haber un empate. Me reitero en ese aspecto. Había que definir esa situación y buscar un campeón. Más adelante vamos a explicar el por qué yo entiendo que en un tipo de combate de esta naturaleza y muchos otros no debe existir un empate cuando se presentan dos seres humanos de diferentes características y diferentes voluntades.
He has never really been in trouble. He was staggered early on, but has come back in fine fashion. Another good right. Oh, Rosario would not appear to be having any particular trouble against the southpaw. This is the third time in his career that he's fought a left-hander. Third time reportedly in his career. Halfway through the 10th round. Ramirez, and this has been a posture the two have had with great frequency in this fight. Now Rosario backs away, but Ramirez has had Rosario against the ropes on a couple of occasions. Decent combination just thrown by Rosario, but back comes Ramirez now, pressing the issue. Ramirez stalking him across the ring. Good exchange by the two here in the 10th round, under a minute to go in round 10. And a mouse developing under the left eye of Rosario. Rosario has been only 10 rounds once in his career. As we say, undefeated, and only once had he gone the distance. Ramirez really coming on now here in the latter round and scoring effectively here in the 10th round. Good action-packed round as we approach the 10-second mark in round 10. Rosario and Ramirez for the WBC lightweight championship.
Creo que no debe haber duda en la mente de ustedes de quién fue el ganador del asalto anterior. Lo describió y tiene un nombre, se llama José Luis Ramírez, un nombre apabullando prácticamente al puertorriqueño. Pero ese extra que tienen los grandes peleadores lo va a demostrar en este asalto el Chapo Rosario, que tiene que estar dando las gracias. Tenemos el reglamento ese de pelear solamente dos asaltos por el título, porque estaba sumamente preocupado en su esquina luego de que ese ataque a mansalva de parte de Ramírez en el asalto anterior. Vamos a disfrutar de esta parte final del combate.
It begins with Rosario backed against the ropes by Ramirez. Rosario had a mouse developing under his left eye in the 10th round, and that left eye just beginning to close a little bit here in the 11th round. Puffiness. This is the longest he has ever gone in his career. And he is showing the effects of the lengthiest bout of his career, and also, obviously, the 11-month layoff from the ring, despite the fact he's only 20 years old. Now he begins to come on again, and the crowd responds, but he's unable to follow it up with much. Round 11, and the pattern in this round, as it's been for the last few, is that Rosario has been giving up ground as Ramirez keeps coming in. Three judges scoring at ringside from Dallas, Las Vegas, and Los Angeles. Fighter Bynum, Lou Tabbitt, Lou Filippo. If they're scoring on the basis of aggression, it's Ramirez who's been picking up a lot of points, because he has been making the latter half of the fight. In the final minute of round 11, scheduled for 12. Rosario, despite being pressed into the corner, has been landing some effective blows. Good right hand, a good right by Ramirez, but Rosario comes right back at him. Right above us, the southpaw landing a good right hook. The 11th round winding down. We've had plenty of action as we come to you live from San Juan, Puerto Rico. Yeah. program note, Battle of the Network Stars annual edition coming up this Wednesday, 9 o'clock, 8 Central, here on ABC. Now the crowd really coming to life as we start the 12th and final round under the new WBC rules. World Lightweight Championship at stake. It's been a good one. Rosario and Ramirez in the crowd chanting Chapo, Chapo. The nickname of Edwin Rosario, ranked number one by the WBC. Ramirez ranked number two. The two battling for Arguello's vacated crown. Rosario, in most corners, was favored coming in. Final round. Ramirez again pressing the action here. Good right landed there by Ramirez, forcing Rosario back into the corner. Ramirez certainly the fresher of the two as this fight winds down. We're halfway through the 12th round. Ramirez has been landing some very effective blows in the second half of this fight. Again, pressuring Rosario, who still has that mouse underneath his left eye, that eye partially closing in the last three rounds. So the southpaw out of Mexico in his 87th fight. And Rosario from here in Puerto Rico at the age of 20 with a minute remaining here in San Juan. Both men showing throughout their careers the ability to knock their opponents out and normally do it very early. But this one apparently will go the distance with 40 seconds remaining in the 12th round. Again, another good right hand by Ramirez. He's not landing the overwhelming punches, but he has done a tremendous amount of scoring. Good exchange here, and Rosario came out of that corner with a good right hand. But again, it's Ramirez showing no ill effects at all. And again, backing Rosario into the corner. So this one winding down, and we've had a lot of action in it from San Juan. Ramirez and Rosario. It's all over, and it's interesting, and you can speculate forever as to what might have happened.
Bien, ya ha finalizado este peleón extraordinario donde vimos un puertorriqueño hacer una demostración increíble solamente y escasamente 20 años de edad con menos de 30 combates frente a un hombre de cerca de 90 combates, que definitivamente el mexicano Ramírez fue un formidable oponente toda la ruta. Pero Rosario, entendemos nosotros, logró la victoria de forma ajustada. Había compulsoriamente, aunque no escrito y no inducido por el Consejo Mundial, que sacar un campeón en esta pelea. Y pusieron tres oficiales que básicamente se han caracterizado por atreverse a votar. Cuando usted no se atreve a votar, usualmente marca empate el asalto. En combates que no tienen importancia y la naturaleza de este, pues usualmente pasan desapercibidos. Pero en esta ocasión el Consejo trató de que vinieran jueces que determinaran un campeón al concluir los 12 capítulos. Y aunque por escaso margen, realmente nos debemos sentir sumamente orgullosos del trabajo realizado por el puertorriqueño Edwin Rosario, que en adición, punto aparte, hay que mencionar el magnífico trabajo de Manny Siaka y su esquina, que trabajó verdaderamente técnicamente orientado el puertorriqueño para salvar la distancia de los 12 asaltos luego de cerca de un año de inactividad y enfrentándose a un zurdo de esa naturaleza tan peligroso.
Say goodbye on this. All right.
Bien, y vamos a resumir cómo votaron los jueces. Luz Filippo votó a favor del Chapo Rosario en proporción de 115 por 113. Luz Taba también a favor del Chapo, 115-113. Y para concluir, los tres jueces votaron de igual forma, lo que indudablemente refleja de que el combate fue cerrado, pero había que sacar un ganador. Y en este tipo de naturaleza, a menos que usted coja dos robots y mecánicamente los oriente por una computadora y los ponga a pelear y los programe para empate, se puede producir empate. Pero bajo condiciones de bregar con seres humanos, definitivamente no puede haber empate. Más frente a un hombre, en ese caso, no quiero señalar el aspecto porque soy puertorriqueño igual que el Chapo y se pudiera terminar que no hay objetividad. Pero con 20 años de edad, habiendo demostrado hace un año hasta la saciedad que tenía unas condiciones excelentes para convertirse en virtual monarca mundial, con mejor pegada, sentido de la distancia, una estamina increíble que la demostró, no empecé el año el hecho de un año en actividad y peleando frente a un hombre zurdo de la naturaleza de José Luis Ramírez, pues definitivamente tenían que sacar un campeón. Y usted tiene que preguntarse, ¿quién va a llegar más lejos? Independientemente del resultado del combate, si el muchacho está lastimado. El de 20 años, que ha demostrado, lógicamente, que es un hombre de una calidad excepcional, o aquel veterano guerrero, gladiador mexicano José Luis Ramírez, que siempre se ha quedado corto. El extra ese que le faltó frente a Bum Bum Mancini, Rubén Olivares y Alexis Argüello, le faltó verdaderamente ese día en el Coliseo Roberto Clemente. A nombre de todos los compañeros de Guapa Televisión, verdaderamente ha sido un gran placer para su amigo de siempre Rafa Bracero haber estado esta noche con ustedes y esperamos que hayan disfrutado realmente de esta interesante velada boxística. A nombre de todos, en el mismo propio, hasta una próxima ocasión, que pasen todos buenas noches, amigos.
El juez Albanum vota 115-113. Decision, Edwin Rosario, the 20-year-old from Puerto Rico, who had not fought in nearly a year, and there is a very disappointed, obviously, Jose Luis Ramirez.